you can remember?
Was Roosevelt,
Yeah, Roosevelt was, I remember him, and he's the one that was in when the war was going on, you know.
Right.
He's the one that declared war on Japan.
Do you remember prior to that, any president prior to that?
No.
So you remember Truman and Eisenhower and...
Oh yeah, them, they're back, just the way, you know.
Right.
Roosevelt, Hoover, President Hoover, and come on down the guys like Nixon, Bush. And
your folks were married 50-some years? Your parents were married about 55 years?
Yeah, at least.
Who passed away first, your mom or your dad?
My mother.
What did she pass away from?
Sugar diabetes. And my dad, he passed away, it wasn't too long after that, wasn't it? Probably a couple of years.
When was that?
Where?
When? You're not sure when they passed away, but it's been a long time, obviously, but...
Yeah.
That's been 40 years or more.
Because mm-hmm. You weren't around when they...
I was just born. I was probably within 2 years, don't you think?
Well, when his dad died?
Both
of
them. Oh. Mm-hmm.
I guess that's right. They were 2 years apart. No. Mm-hmm. All right, so you're out and you got the family history. Are we done with that? Anybody else?
How'd they move here? When did he meet Grandma?
Well, let's see. You're still out in the oil fields, right?
Yeah.
You're out in the oil fields in Oklahoma.
What kind of Christmases did you have when you were in that little dugout house?
We was only there one Christmas, and I remember that we didn't have a Christmas tree. We had set Mama made bread, and we'd set a bread pan. That's what we had got our presents in, the little bread pan. And this is only one Christmas we were there. And I had to be 2 years younger, 2 years or younger. And I remember this, we didn't want to go to sleep, we wanted to wait up for Santa Claus. And it was 25 miles to town, by horse and wagon.
Wow.
So the folks had gone to town for that. And we never had a green Christmas tree when we come to Oregon. And what we would do, my mother and girls would go out in the woods and cut a tree that had a lot of little limbs on it and everything like that, and we'd wrap it with green paper, the limbs with green paper, and then we'd put string cranberries and popcorn for the decoration.
No lights, or probably didn't have candles. Did you have candles?
Well, yeah, they had candles, but they
weren't putting them on there.
They, believe it or not, they put candles on green Christmas trees in churches and in schools. And those little old bitty candles like they have for birthday, you know?
Uh-huh.
And they go in a little holder, and it had a little clip on them. And they could clip that on the limbs.
Hmm.
And you had to be careful where you clipped them on there, and then get in and set the tree on fire.
Hmm.
And if I remember right, they had then several fires till they finally outlawed the candles on the trees. And then,
I have the schools.
And snow to school. No, well, I've heard it before from other people, but I didn't know you, it happened to you, too.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, we had a lot. And where the school was closest to our house, we would live down, we was out of the district. So we had to pay tuition, and I worked for the, I went early and built fires in the school and swept the floor to pay our tuition for school.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. And we,
To pay for you and your sisters?
Huh?
To pay for you and your sisters?
Yeah, that was my youngest sister. And
so you really did have to walk away?
Oh, yes. Yeah, we walked.
How far?
Well, this one school, where we was at, we probably did walk around 5 miles.
Wow. That's a long ways.
Mm-hmm.
To and from each day.
Yeah, see, the snow and cold.
Yeah, you hear those stories, but it sounds like you actually did it.
But there wasn't no such a thing as a school bus. Anywhere.
How long was your school day?
How long was the school day?
Yeah.
Well, it's about, I think school took up around 9 o'clock and let out at 4.
Just one room?
Huh?
Just one room?
Yeah, this one school where I paid tuition had 2 rooms. But the other one we went to only had 1 room. I had, see, they had eight grades in 1 room.
Hmm. That's interesting.
How many were in your class? How many was in the school, I mean?
I don't remember just how many, but they have quite a few.
The room pretty good size, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
So, what do you remember about your later teenage years? You obviously started working somewhere.
Yeah, I went to Oklahoma City and stayed with my sister and brother-in-law down there, and went to work for Phillips Petroleum Building, working in construction gasoline plants. And I had an application then to go to work for Santa Fe Trail, for Southern Kansas Stage Line. And at that time, you had to go to...
Move your hand.
Huh?
Move your hand so we can hear
you. At that time, you had to go to Wichita to hire out, and they changed it. I didn't know it. So I went all the way to Wichita, and I got up there. They didn't even know about me. I wanted to go to work for them.
They didn't have your application?
So I had to go back to Oklahoma City, where they did the hiring right there, you know. So I started to work for them, and worked for them until we came to Oregon.
You went into the Navy.
Was that before you came?
Oh, yeah. No, that's when I was still there.
You went into the Navy?
I was still working for Santa Fe when I went to the Navy. I was dispatching the pickup trucks all over town. We had about 25. And I was dispatching these trucks. And I went to the Navy. And then when I come back, well, my seniority went on all the time when I was gone. And when I come back, I bumped the guy off of the job and took it back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How old were you when you went to the Navy?
Well, I think it's probably about 18. But when I did, I got in just not too long before the war was over. But I didn't have to go to them. They couldn't have drafted me at all, because we were hauling down the trade all the time, and my job was figured essential job, and they couldn't have drafted me. And I knew that, but I wasn't joined anyway.
Why?
And, well, I just wanted to go in, I guess.
You wanted to go in for a while?
And, so I went and joined up, then went to Providence, Rhode Island, and took Marine training up there. And then they put us in a special detachment, went to Halifax, Nova Scotia, and got the Queen Elizabeth, went across to Glasgow, Scotland. And it was in a on the base there in the Clyde River. Down Dumbarton. Let's see, Dumbarton, I think, was the place where we went across over to the island. And then we stayed on that base, and it's making up convoys to go different places. And they was taking the guys out of this detachment, you know, and replacing other guys. And the war was just about over, and then they quit making up their deposit, so they sent us home then. So we came back, when we came back home, we got discharged. And I went back to Saturday and took my old job back.
How many years was it when were you in the Navy?
Oh, it wasn't very long. It wasn't probably a couple of years. It was right when the war was ready to end.
What was it like riding on that boat over to...
It was like riding what?
The boat. The ship. Queen Elizabeth. What was it like?
Well, you'd think a big boat like that would be smooth, but that rough thing, we got in a storm the second day out, and I think everybody on the boat practically was seasick. I never did get seasick, though. And pretty near everybody on some of them got sick and never got out of the bunk all the way across.
And rocking around too much.
And there was 20,000 soldiers and sailors on the ship there, and we had you had to take a number. When you go to the chow, you know, to eat, and it was like 2 o'clock in the morning, 2 o'clock in the afternoon, or 4, whatever your number was, and it was that time, and if you weren't there at that time, you didn't eat. And because there's so many, they just kept feeding around the clock, you know. Because they couldn't stop. And if your number was 4 in the morning, you had to be there 4 in the morning, 4 in the afternoon. And worked out.
That was the Queen Elizabeth II, yeah. Or the Queen Elizabeth, the original? Yeah, the
Queen Elizabeth.
The original ship.
That's the original. That was the biggest ship on the water at that time.
How long did it take to go across?
I think it was only about 4 days going across.
So when you arrived there, as being in the Navy, they just put you in barracks, or did you...
You mean after we got across there?
Mm-hmm.
Well, there's Quonset huts. You know what Quonset huts are?
Yeah.
There were Quonset huts, and they were just kind of like tents. How they were, I guess, kind of... Do you have Quonset huts over there now? No, it was Brandon.
Yeah, over in Saudi?
Yeah. I think they had Quonset hut they stayed in over there. It was like that, you know.
Tents. They were in tents.
Yeah, I guess it was partly tents, too.
So what would you do every day if you weren't training or you weren't doing anything? What were you doing?
Nothing. We were just there on the base and waiting, you know. And, of course, we had air raids every day because they had to... In the daytime, they put up these barrage balloons, they call them. They had girls that manned these trucks. They had a great big barrage balloon. It's like that Goodyear balloon that goes over, you know. Only it's a barrage balloon. And these girls would go out there, and they had a winch on there, and they'd lift this thing out and put this... So they couldn't come in there close on the base in the daytime. But they'd come back at night. A lot of times, and drop bombs around and everything they would do.
Why didn't they keep those balloons up during the day or during the night?
And, you know, it's a good question, but I don't know the answer to that, but they didn't.
Because, I mean, they were to deter the planes from coming in they were afraid that it seemed like at night they would be more effective because the pilots couldn't see them and they'd be afraid to come in.
Yeah, you'd think so, but I don't know why. They just put them up in the daytime.
Yeah, it seems odd. Mm-hmm. So you're in a blackout at night, right?
Oh, yeah.